Okay, so this video is going to be for task 10 and 11, which is the petty cash and the journals. Okay, very short video, and I'll do a separate video for bank reconciliation and then reports. Okay, so this is a video for task 10 and task 11. So let's open the question paper first. So this is your task 9, which we completed. Task 10 is petty cash vouchers, which we need to enter into the accounting software. Okay, so we have 3 petty cash vouchers, one for stationery, one for travel, and the other one also train fare, which also is travel. Voucher numbers 124, 125 and 126 on the 9th, 9th and the 14th of June. First one has got VAT, but the other two has no VAT, so we need to use T0. Okay, so petty cash vouchers. So in the sage, dealing with money again, so we go to bank. Petty cash voucher is a payment. You are making a payment to somebody else. Okay, so we go to payment and choose bank payment. But petty cash payment do not go from the bank account, so change the number to 1230. So do not forget to do that. If you don't do that, these petty cash vouchers will go into the bank and you will end up doing a mistake. Okay, so petty cash 1230, highlight that account in bank payments. I'm showing that again to you. So you choose payment, bank payment. Instead of 1200 over here, change the account to 1230. The first petty cash payment was on the 9th of June, so select the date. It was for stationery, so select your stationery account which you should have created before. Petty cash voucher number was 124 and the amount is £6 and the VAT is T1, so I am removing addresses. Next one also the same thing again, into the petty cash on the 9th of June again. This time it was for traveling, so choose your travel account. We have travel and subsistence, so we use that. Voucher number 125. Amount is £14 and no VAT this time. So enter £14 and change the tax code to T0. The last voucher is on the 14th of June for 475 again. So again 1230 on the 14th of June for travel again, train fare. Voucher number 126. Amount was £4.75 and change the tax code to T0 and say OK. And then that's all the 3 petty cash vouchers what we have done. So save it and close. Next, task 10 is finished. Task 11 is journals. We usually do journals when there is any error. Okay, as you read in bookkeeping controls, journals are used to do error corrections. So when you are writing a journal, it's very important for you to include this detailed step also. Okay, why you are doing this. Okay, so to do the journal, which is your task 11, you go to nominal codes and journal entry. So you go to nominal codes and journal entry. Then let's start off the first journal entry, which is on the 30th of June. Computer equipment account is debited and fixtures and fittings account is credited. So you have to do both the debits and credits because you're writing the journal fully. So first choose your computer equipment account, which is debited 95. Don't worry why is this done, because that is just an error which you are correcting. So you don't have to worry why this is done and everything. You just need to enter it. Fixtures and fittings is credited. Make sure you write the details according to the question paper. It was incorrectly coded non-current asset. That's why we are doing this. Write the same details in the next box also. Incorrectly coded non-current asset. And then do the second journal also here itself. You don't have to save and open. Second journal is wages and bank. There's a mistake in the wages account, error in wages. You have to put wages 2595 and bank 2595 on the credit. So wages 2595 on the debit and bank, which is 1200, as you know, 2595 on the credit. Reason for this is error in wages amount recorded. Error in wages amount. Under the reference, you can write journal entry. You don't have to do it, it's up to you. Journal 1 and 2. So both the journals are together entered. And then that is done. Now if you do any mistake in journal, you cannot delete it. Okay, so please be very careful with the journal entries. You cannot delete them. Okay, so journal I entered. First journal is computer equipment debited and fixtures and fittings credited. Next one was wages debited and bank current account credited. So save it and close. If you go to the transactions, you can see all of them here. Okay. So you had petty cash payments, 3. You can see 1230, 1230, 1230. Then you had 2 journals, 1 and then 2. Double entries for both of them, okay? So that is your task 10 and 11.